Hello, Internet. I'm your only mate, and it's time for another death battle. This time we have Danny Phantom versus Jake Long, the American Dragon. Or is that American Dragon Jake Long? I don't actually know. I don't really know these two that well, but regardless, as I should say before, any reaction, please click the link in the description below, whether it be to watch the video on the Rooster Teeth website or on YouTube. I keep forgetting it every single time, but point is, support the official release, watch the original video before you watch mine, or anyone else's reactions. Don't be a dick. Alright, so, I kind of said just there that I don't really know these characters that well. I know of them, like I heard about Danny Phantom a lot more, but not so much Jake Long, although a friend of mine posted a review, and, yeah, it's, some of the stuff just doesn't sound like it's for me. But anyway, so I do want to mention a little something, and it's that Butch Hartman, the creator of Danny Phantom, turns out he's actually a Death Battle fan, and he's very, very excited for this episode. So, yeah, that's something that doesn't happen very often, the creator of the character being, oh my god, I love this show and they're doing my character, this is awesome. Like, it doesn't happen all that often, so it's really nice to see. As for who I think is going to win, I honestly don't know enough to make an educated guess, although I know the general consensus is that people believe that Danny is going to win. So I guess for now I'll just go with that. But, yeah, that's pretty much all I really have to say. Although, we are just about to find out what the mid-season finale is. I'm anticipating that quite a bit. So, yeah, I really don't know what else to say, so I'm just gonna shut the fuck up and hit play. Do, do, do.
There's a thin line between the natural and the supernatural. And for some reason, the weirdest of powers keep showing up in teens.
When's it yeah.
Turn? Danny Phantom, Amity Park's half-human, half-ghost superhero. And Jake Long, the hip American dragon of New York City. He's Wiz and I'm Boomstick.
And it's our job to analyze their weapons, armor, and skills to find out who would win a death battle. Oh, before I forget, Ivan, your most wanted fight. Great that it's happening.
A very strange machine. It was designed to view a world unseen. He's gonna catch them all, cause he's standing...
Boomstick's singing the theme song.
Let's focus on his backstory. What do you mean? I just did. In song. Fair enough. Danny wasn't...
He's not wrong.
...from your usual high school teenager. A bit awkward, a bit geeky, but not unusual. Except for the fact that his parents had taken up a very unusual profession. Yeah! Hunting ghosts!
They're Ghostbusters, I guess.
Portal, meant to open a rift to the realm of spirits. The Ghost Zone! But then Danny took a look inside of it. There was a great big flash. Everything just changed.
Wait, why is he on an off switch on the inside?
Okay, I'll stop. Unbeknownst to his parents, the portal permanently changed Danny's body, transforming him into a Hapa, or a human infused with ecto energy. AKA Ghost Powers!
Just face some ghost.
And when ghosts started invading the living world, Danny took it upon himself to catch them all. And despite this show starting in the early 2000s, that's not talking about Pokemon. Weird coincidence. He soon became known as the supernatural superhero, Danny Phantom.
It's Phantom! Danny Phantom!
And for some reason, nobody figured out that Danny Fenton was Danny Phantom.
Oh my god.
Maybe they were just playing along? He is a kid after all. Nah, they're stupid. To catch ghosts...
Yeah, I'm gonna go with stupid.
...gadgets, including the Fenton Thermos. Once a clever way to sneak your beer into concerts, now a device that sucks up and traps the undead. Wait a minute. Is this kid a Ghostbuster? Or, I guess...
Pretty much from the sounds of it. Yes, Ghostbuster.
Way, but Danny's ghastly form meant he could do many things that Bill Murray could not.
He can do anything a ghost can, like floating around and spooking the shit out of people.
He can fly.
That sounds fun.
Spirits, freeze foes with ice, create equally spectral clones of himself, possess others, turn invisible, and expel ectoplasmic energy in the form of barriers and attacks.
Okay, that's pretty awesome.
Laser shooting ghost.
Ectoplasma.
Whatever. He can fire beams from his eyes, his finger, and even his spectral sphincter.
What?
I guess that's why they call him ghastly.
Maybe I love boomsticks, like they'll just...
His most exhausting ability is his ghostly wail.
This one comes from the other end.
I've heard some people bring this up.
He really is a teenager.
This wail is an omnidirectional burst of ectoplasmic energy, which, at its strongest, can eradicate weaker ghosts in a single shot.
What the fuck?
See, just like that.
Why?
Danny's
also, how did Boomstick learn how to do that?
Fighter again and again, like the time he went Kamehameha on this poor skeleton at a mini golf course.
Comparing Danny's size to the crater formed.
Oh Jesus!
Needed to vaporize this much terrain would be in the ball or golf park of around 550 tons of TNT.
Plus, damn.
Ectoplasmic beams tend to be considered actual lasers.
I knew it.
They move in straight lines, burn on contact, bounce off reflective surfaces, and can be channeled through a magnifying glass, so they are likely comparable to light in both makeup and speed.
And he's shooting and dodging on a daily basis. You'd think with speed like that, he'd never be late for class, or get smacked by some of these heavy hitters like his nemesis Vlad or this dragon lady, Dorothea.
Dorothea's fire breath was powerful enough to disperse a large cloud formation. Measuring the distance between this castle and the outskirts, we determined the cloud would, at minimum, need a radius of over 300 meters to encompass the landmass the castle is situated on.
All right, and that's how many...
Of that size would need over 7 kilotons...
There it is.
He even beat up his future self, Dan Phantom. Because, I guess, you know, that shows that he's matured, because he... Dan now.
As powerful as Danny is, he's
just not as catchy
and has all the arrogance and moodiness that comes with the territory.
And he's got a really bad habit of losing his powers in the most random ways possible. Meet a genie? Power's gone. Shrink ray? Sure, why the hell not?
What?
I'm surprised he didn't trip into his own thermos at some point. Oh wait, he did.
Dan has saved his hometown and the entire world time and time again. He had to stop all the ghosts that were coming through. He's here to fight for you. Oh, damn it, now you have me doing
it. It is a catchy theme.
Yes, the future isn't as set in stone as you think it is.
All right. Oh, let's see what Jake's got.
A group of mystic warriors were formed. This was the Hunts Clan. And their mission was to eliminate all magical creatures from the world.
But these Foot Clan wannabes were in over their heads thanks to the most powerful creatures of them all, the dragons. In short,
dragons are pretty damn awesome.
A dragon tasked as a guardian of the magical community. This mantle is passed down generation by generation.
So after the Chinese dragon's daughter moved to America, her son became the first American dragon, Jake Long. He's cool, he's hot, like the frozen sun. He's young and fast, he's the...
I'm not gonna lie, I don't think... Like, just comparing the theme song, I think Danny's is way better.
Episode, aren't you?
Probably.
Jake was only 13 years old when he became the newest protector of magic. His responsibilities became tough to handle alongside school and friends.
Lucky for Jake, he didn't have to go it alone. His grandfather was his mentor in martial arts and all things dragon, and had a magical dog. Foo Dog, who I'm pretty sure has a higher body count than any of this show's villains.
Oh, well, considering that, yeah, probably.
Devil. I learned how to fight bears from watching.
Jesus.
I'll never let go.
To be clear, Jake possessed the ability to transform into a draconic persona, complete with brand new physique and abilities.
Oh, duh, he's a freaking dragon! He's got the claws, the teeth, the tail, the wings, and of course, the raging, burning fire breath! He was throwing fire from his
mouth, love dragons.
His hands, and even his burning beehole!
Oh, really? You can do that too?
Nah, his dragon... Dragon forms in super top condition. He's even got ultra sight and vision thanks to his eye and ear of the dragon powers. Perfect for when some pesky ninja punks are trying to get the jump on you. God, I hate it when that happens. That's why it's always important to have anti-ninja protection.
Oh, why God.
Sign up for that.
Why do you think I bought 10,000 screaming rubber chickens? Try and step foot in my shack, you stealth assholes.
What?
He doesn't even need to transform fully to use these powers. Technically, Jake can morph individual parts of his body at will.
Man, I wish I could transform into a dragon.
I'm guessing that's been really inconvenient for him at times.
Magical fire-breathing super lizard.
The key word being magic.
But I just
yep, he can fight
doing it at the wrong time or something.
Ordinary people can't, including ghosts. He can even use his cheek.
I remember hearing that, like, a long time ago, that Jake can actually punch ghosts.
Tough enough to smash through steel, hold up a pillar, and annihilate a house with a simple sneeze. He can produce enough flame to obliterate several sheets of stone. Measuring the size of the hole here next to the girl.
Okay, that's some pretty powerful fire breath.
Million cubic centimeters of stone, which would need over 30 tons of TNT.
All right, Danny's was bigger.
Which was a massive 10,000 kilogram nuke. You wonder if Jake ever uses breath mints?
He can also fly over 100 miles per hour, moving from ground to cloud level in mere seconds.
And he can dodge lasers too, and they're totally light lasers.
Oh, okay.
Mirrors, straight, consistent speed, all that stuff.
Jake has accomplished a lot as the Amdrag of New York City.
Oh,
but
God,
it wasn't
that
always easy.
Yeah, being a teenager's hard. Not to mention keeping his powers a secret from his monster-hating dad. Really landed a winner there, Mom, whose own father is a dragon monster.
He's defeated the Hunts clan over and over, fought off his own evil clone, and even outdid the Dark Dragon himself.
The ultimate dragon! Top-tier dragos around the world are scared shitless of this guy, but Jake whooped his butt and sealed him away for good. Or at least for the next 1,000 years. That'll be
sounds about right.
Unfortunately, Jake has one distinct, unavoidable weakness. Sphinx hair.
Like
what?
The Egyptian lion riddle lady?
Exactly.
Well, that's not random at all.
Young and brash though he may be,
that's
the
weird.
World can rest assured that Jake Long will carry on the dragon's legacy.
He really is the hippest fire-breathing super lizard out there.
Dragon off!
Pause. Okay. So I was thinking, okay, so if Jake doesn't have anything to like compete with Danny's speed, then Danny's probably gonna win, but they did mention how he can also like dodge like actual lasers and whatnot, so there goes that. However, I did note that Danny's feat of like destroying the golf course and whatnot was bigger than Jake's thing, and they also brought up the dragon that could separate the clouds and whatnot. I didn't hear anything like that for Jake. I didn't catch anything in the sidebar. I don't know if it was there. So it sounds to me like Danny's a tad more powerful. And it sounds like he also has like more versatile abilities. Like the whole invisibility, phasing through stuff, and whatnot. So yeah, through like the sheer power output and the versatility, I think I'm gonna go with Danny for this one. But shut up, hit play, and see the rest of this fight, because I did see the preview on Death Battlecast and it looks good so far, and I want to see the rest.
All right, the combatants are set.
And we've run the data through all possibilities.
It's time for a death battle.
All right. Let's do this. I love how they have that do-do-do-do-do, like, in the music, like, right as it starts.
There. Back where it belongs. Yo.
Also, this really does look like pixelated, like, cartoons, really. So, man, props to you, Lewis. Lewis. Sorry, I'm not so great today. And boom. I can't help but find that funny. Man, Danny's just straight up dominating at the beginning. And from here on, 100% blind. Ooh!
Wanna try something else? I don't want this to drag on.
How's this? And he can punch ghosts, so there's your surprise, Danny.
Eye of the dragon. Where'd he go?
Okay, switch it up environment. Ah, fire versus ice. Versus blue cameo.
Not a bad trick, G. But anything you can do, I can do better.
Oh god. Jesus Christ. There's a lot going on here. It's like when like four clones of Goku fought four clones of Cell. Alright, come on, Danny. Pull this through.
Guess I was too hot for him. But I'm way
cooler.
Get out! D to the A to the N and Y. This dragon's got claws and waits to fly.
God.
But I'm still better than this other guy.
Oh. Oh shit!
Time's up, pal.
KO. Well, looks like I like how he turned the like rap rhyme around at the end. Unique
matchup. With both fighters having such different power sets, it was fascinating to watch them clash together. Jake was technically more skilled thanks to his grandfather's martial arts training, and has proven capable of harming ghosts. But Danny's power and plethora of abilities was difficult for him to counter.
Exactly what I said. I feel good.
Few more battles than Jake. Plus, Jake's never dealt with a ghost as powerful as Danny. Those cranky Civil War spirits didn't exactly have ice beams and ghost lasers.
While they may have been similar in light speed reactions, Danny's flight speed was definitely higher. Also, Jake's fire was comparable to three GBU-43 warheads, commonly referred to as fireball bombs.
Here it comes.
However,
the sheer power difference.
700 of them,
and Danny took those flames on like a champ. Which means Jake didn't have the firepower he needed to knock the teenage ghost down for good.
Danny could overpower Jake's fire with his ecto projectiles, match Jake's duplicates with his own, and even slip past Jake's heightened senses.
I still love the Red vs. Blue billboard.
All those counters, Jake didn't have any against Danny's will or possession.
Jake may be the American dragon for good reason, but he couldn't match up to Danny's impressive power, durability, and ghostly abilities.
It didn't take long for Jake to fall short in this fantastic battle.
The winner is Danny Phantom.
Congrats, Danny.
Hey,
all right, moment of truth. Mid-season finale. What is it?
Link down below. And if you want to watch more stuff, check the boxes right over there.
Oh! Well, that was timed perfectly. Okay, so I feel like I enjoyed that fight a lot more than I thought I would. Because admittedly, if I'm not like as invested in the characters, then I'm not like expecting a whole lot from it. But I had fun with this episode. Like, it was funny, it was awesome, it was well done, and they made both characters sound really good. And I don't know, maybe if they get around to it, but keep in mind I'm a lazy bastard, I might end up at least watching Danny Phantom, because that, out of the two, it sounds more appealing to me. So yeah, and yeah, that's just about it. So the mid-season finale is She-Ra versus Wonder Woman. Okay, and the reason I said it was perfectly timed, because She-Ra Princess of Power just wrapped up the other day. So that was timed oh so freaking perfectly. And I just so happened to tweet out, hey, now that it's wrapped up, which character would you like to see in a death battle? And I think at least someone did say She-Ra versus Wonder Woman. So that was a thing. And oh yeah, this means it's like Wonder Woman's third time in death battle, because it was like Rogue, Four, and now She-Ra. Right, and I know like a fair amount of She-Ra, like just based on the Princess of Power show. Like I did enjoy that. I don't know a whole lot about the original though, but I'm gonna assume she's on a similar level to like He-Man, who is strong enough to push a moon. So, and I don't know like much beyond that from what I remember of He-Man's death battle. At the moment, I want to put my money on Wonder Woman. But I don't know. They could be something like bizarre that She-Ra's done. Might just be like, oh wow, Wonder Woman's screwed. Or something like that, I don't know. But, yeah, that was a fun episode, and I'm looking forward to the season finale. Well, mid season finale. So yeah. Alright, well, I should probably wrap this up. Thanks for watching all of that stuff. And here's whatever outro is next in the cycle, because I keep forgetting. Bye.
This is Ruby Rose, and you've been watching Your Only Mate. Bye!